and fit at your place. So today we are here with a new video of MS Word 2010. Here in this video we will learn about some practical work, that how we can save our file, how we can open a new document, how we can open any existing file, how we can save a file with the password protection. So for further knowledge or the practical work, we will move to our Windows screen where we can learn a lot of things.
So students, here in this video we will learn some basic commands that how we can start the work with MS Word or a word processor. So first we will learn that how we can open the MS Word. We have two ways to open the MS Word. First, we have to go through the run option directly, and the shortcut key to open the run in your computer or in your laptop is Window plus R. Once you get the run window, then you have to type the keyword WinWord here, WINWORD, and then you have to click on the OK button. It will show you the entire screen of MS Word. This is the first way. The second way is, if you are having the Window 10 in your computer system, then you have to click on the Start button, and then you have to select the Microsoft Office. Then in that Microsoft Office, you have to select the application Microsoft Office Word 2007. Then again, you will get the Microsoft Office window on your screen, Microsoft Word window. And if you are having the Windows 7 in your computer, then you have to go through the Start, then All Programs, then Accessories. Then you will go through that particular software, whatever you want or in which you want to work in. So here, this is the entire screen of MS Word. This button, this rounded button, it is called the Office button. Office button, basically, it provides us the option like New, Open, Save, Save As, Print, Prepare, Send, Publish, and Close option. Just next to the Office button, there is a small bar from here to here. This bar is called the Quick Access bar. Quick Access bar contains by default three menus like Save, Undo, and Redo. The bar that is found at the top of the window, it is called the Title bar. Basically, it displays us the title of our document. Here, at the end of the Title bar, there are three things. These are called the Windows Controller. That contains the Minimize, Maximize, and Restore button. And this one is the Close option. Just below the Title bar, there is the another bar that contains the menu like Home, Insert, Page Layout, Preference, Mailing. These are called the menu bars, or we will also call it tabs. Just below this bar, there is another bar that is called the Toolbar, that contains the tool of MS Word that allows the user to perform the formatting task on the document. So this is your toolbar. Just below this, there are some things like clipboard, font, paragraph, styles, editing. These are the groups. A group contains basically the similar elements of that use. Like paragraph group contain all the tools that is related with the paragraph. Just below this, one more thing that you have to keep in your mind from here to here. This is called the ribbon. From the menu bar to this group area, this is called the ribbon. Just below this, there are two rulers like horizontal one and vertical one. This is called the scroll bar that allows you to scroll up your page and scroll down your page. This is the work area where you can work or where you can type the things. Just below this, there is a bar called the status bar that tells you the status of your page, like types, number of words typed in your document, the current page on which you are working, page number 1 and 2, and the bottom. At the bottom of the desktop screen or this window, this bar, that bar is called the taskbar. Taskbar tells us or it shows us the currently working document. Now, I'll tell you that how to create a Word document. If you're not having any Word document, then you have to click on the Office button. In this Office button, you will go through the New option. In that new option, you have number of things. A window will appear on your screen that contains the blank and recent installed templates. You can also start your work with the templates, greeting cards, gift certificates. But if you want to create a new document, then you have to select the blank document from here and then go through the create option. So this thing appears on your screen, or you have to press a key combination, that is Control plus N, to open the new window. The new document then appears on your screen. The next thing is how to save a document in MS Word. So the Word document allows us to create exist in temporary storage area, means we can store the data in the temporary storage area also. If you want to use that document in future, then you must have the save document. So for that, you have three ways to save your document. The shortcut key, the first method is by using the shortcut key combination, that is Control plus S. And if we press the Control plus S, then a dialog box save as will appear on your screen. This is the first way. The second way is that you have to go through the office button. In that office button, you have to select the save option or the save button. This is the second way. And the third way is you have to choose the save option from the quick access bar. This is the save option, and you have to choose this from here. And after that, once you get this dialog box on your screen, then here you have to type a desired name that you want to give to your file. Suppose I want to give the name to my file as Word document, W-O-R-D. Then I'll write Word and save as type the Word document. It depends upon your choice. And then you have to select the location where you want to save your file. So if you want to save your file in the desktop, then here you have to select the location. And you have to save this file. Then you will see the changes, that the name of your Word file will be changing to the Word. Now, here, if you want to see the extension of your file, we know that the extension of MS Word file is .docx. So if you want to see the extension of your file, then you have to just go through that particular location where you have saved your file, and then just right click on that particular file and then go to the properties option. Here you will see the extension of your document. The name of your document is Word and the extension is .docx. So if you want to again save your document, then you have to click on the save as option to save your file with more than one name. Now the next thing is how to save a document using the password protection. So sometimes you want to protect your file so that others cannot view it. In this case, you can use the option of protecting the file using a password. To protect an entire document from being viewed by the others, we have to follow few steps, that are, you have to go to the file tab. Then here we have to select on the save as option, and from the drop down menu, a save as dialog box appears on your screen. Here you will see this save as dialog box appears on your screen. Then we have to select the tool tab and select the general option. In that tool tab, we have to go through the general option. Here, this is the save as option. You will select the save as option. Once you click on the save as option, then here you will see the window or a dialog box appear on your screen. Here you have to select the tools option, and in the tools option, go through the select general option. Here this is the general option. Then the general option dialog box will appear with two fields. It will appear with the two fields like password to open and password to modify. Means here, this one is means if you want to open your file, then you have to type the password to open the file. And if you want to perform some changes in that particular file, then you will select the password to modify. So here we have to type the desired password in the password to open field. Suppose I'm writing the password 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to open the file, and the next password is to modify 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, then the confirm password dialog box appears on your screen. Re-enter the password in order to confirm the password. Once I click on the OK button, here this is the confirm password dialog box will reappear. So here I'm also type the password that I have typed first, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then I'll click on the OK button. Re-enter the password to modify, because I have already typed the password, that 126 to modify. Then I'm writing the OK. And I'm saving this file. My file is saved now. So how we can say view that our file is password protected? So I close my file, and once I open it again, then to open that file, it will require a password. So this is the password that we have typed earlier to open the file, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here you will see, if I want to do any modification, any changes, then I have to type the second one password that I have typed. So I'll click on the OK button. Here you have two ways to read only. In that read only case, you will only able to see the password. Now the next thing is how to close a Word document and an application. To close a Word document, we have number of ways. So I have to go through the file option or the office button. Then in this office button, I have to select the close option. Here you will see your file will get closed. Now, if you want to exit from the whole Word document, then you have to select this close button from here. Then it will take you outside from this thing. Now, the next practical is how to open an existing file. Once the document is saved on your computer, and it can be retrieved anytime when it is required by the user. So if you want to open any existing file, you have number of ways to open it. First, you have the first way, and by using the first way, you have to go through the office button, and then you have to go through the open option. Once you click on the open option, then from here you have to select the destination where you saved your file, and then you have to open your file from here. Like if I want to open this ANU file, then I'll click here, then this the file is open now. And the second way is by using the Control plus O shortcut key. This dialog box will again appear on your screen, and this will happen. Now the next thing is how we can customize the quick access bar. Here, this is your quick access bar. By default, it is having three options only: undo, redo, and save. If you want to customize your quick access bar, then you have to go through this customize quick access toolbar, and from here you can select number of options like new, open, save, email, quick print, minimize the ribbon. If you click the minimize the ribbon, then this ribbon will get disappear from your screen. And if you again want to open it, or if you want again want to show it in your screen, then you have to go through with this arrow and click on the minimize the ribbon, then this toolbar will again appears on your screen. Now the next thing is to add the items in your quick access bar. So for that, you have to just right click on this quick access bar and click on the customize quick access toolbar option. Once you click on this option, then you will get a Word option dialog box appear on your screen. From here, you can select the type of command. Suppose I'm working with the popular commands, so I can select the popular commands from here. Right now, I'm having three options: save, undo, and redo. So suppose if I want to insert number of things in that, then I have to select the new option and click on the add button. I also, if I want to insert the open, then I have to click the open and click on the add option. And if I also want to insert the quick print, print preview, whatever the option that I want to insert here, then I can just select it from here, quick print, then I can insert here. And if I want to remove something from here, then I can just simply select it and click on the remove option. So it will remove from the list. Then after that, I have to click on the OK button. So here you have seen the changes. My quick access bar gets customized. So by using this method, you can add or you can remove the elements, and you can also change the position of your quick access bar. From here, you can also show quick access bar below to the ribbon, and then OK. Here you will see your quick access bar appears just below the ribbon. And if you again want to show above, then you have to click on the show above the rear.
So students, that's all about today's information. If you have any doubt, any query related to the video or the presentation, then you can ask me, you can drop a message in the drop box, or you can call me. And one more thing, that you have to complete your work on time and forward it to me. Thank you. Have a nice day.